You know, if we hope to achieve political democracy, we must vigorously pursue economic democracy. So how do we do that at this moment? I mentioned earlier a minimum wage that is a living wage. $15 an hour should be the floor for any job, because I want you to be able to work that one job with everything that you've got, but I also want you to be able to read to your daughter before the first day of kindergarten, every night during first grade, to ensure that she has your attention to achieve to her full potential over the course of her life. I want to make sure that if you need to take time off from work to care for her, for your folks, for yourself, that there's paid family leave, and you're not punished by losing out on income or even your job for just doing what any human should be able to do. I want to make sure that women in this country who are paid 80 cents on the dollar for what men are paid in this country, that African-American women who are paid 61 cents on the dollar, Latinas 53 cents on the dollar, that there's no discrimination in the workplace that further compounds the inequity and inequality that we have in this country, that we ratify the Equal Rights Amendment so that is enshrined in our Constitution and is never a question again. I want to repeal the worst excesses of the Trump tax cuts. Those people of the future, when they look back on 2017 and 2018, they will not be able to believe that at a moment that we were $21 trillion in debt, when we were fighting wars in half a dozen countries around the world, when we had $4 trillion in outstanding infrastructure needs, tens of millions of our fellow Americans who could not get health insurance, that our answer to that was $2 trillion of tax benefits to the wealthiest Americans and to corporations that were already sitting on record piles of cash. That corporate tax rate went from 35% down to 21%. Even if we don't take it all the way back up to where it was, but take it to the mid-20s, we will generate hundreds of billions of dollars over the next 10 years. We could invest that in universal pre-K, starting education not at 4 or 5 years old, but 3 or 4 years old, ensuring that there's a greater likelihood that that child will graduate from high school, go on to earn higher education, or join a union and achieve their full potential over the course of their lives.